Hello people, welcome to Ratan IT and this is Vinisha. In this video session, we are going to discuss the CSS outline. Okay, CSS outline. First, going to this topic, we already discussed it regarding the CSS border, right? CSS border. The same way how we I'm going to specify the border, the same way I'm going to specify the outline. What is the real usage of this? We are going to use this outline after the margin or after the border or around the border. Around the border, we are going to use this outline. This is not an important topic, but sometimes it might be very useful to locate something else, very important things or pointing things. Okay, for that purpose, we are going to even use this outline. So first, what are the properties and what are the values for that properties are there? First, we are going to discuss in the CSS outline. Okay, first thing is, same like border, it is also having a style. That means the outline style, and it is also having a color, and it is also having a width. Okay, first style need to be set, then only these two properties might be given to the outline. Okay, that is what the real concept of outline, same like the border. Okay, you already know that what are the values available for style, that is outline style. See, if I am having a h1 element, for this h1 element I am going to write the CSS outline. Okay, CSS code, if I am having an h1, h1 is my selector over here, outline style. My outline style will be might solid or dotted or ridge or inset, ridge, groove, everything are there. So what are they? Solid, double, dashed, ridge, groove, inset, outset, none, hidden, and many. Okay, these are the available outline style. Okay, in this way we are going to give the values. Here you can give the double or the dash or something else like inset, outset, none, hidden. None means it won't have any outline. Hidden means the outline will be there but it is transparent. Okay, the outline will be there but it is transparent. Let us suppose this will be useful when you will have an image or something like, okay, image, you don't want to show any outline or any border, so just make it border or outline will be there but you kept it hidden. That is the real meaning of using a hidden over there. Solid means it will be displayed in a solid way. Dashed means the dashes will come over like this around the border, complete of border. Okay, dotted means dots will be come over like this. Okay, and ridge, groove, and many available things are there. We are going to see all this in application. At the same time, regarding the color, outline color, we already know that outline color need to be right in CSS like this. Outline color, that outline color you can give in a name wise, you can give the name wise. We already discussed regarding this. Name wise means I can give red or blue or hot pink or green, yellow, in this way. Just name wise I can give my color. Okay, and second, I can also give in hexadecimal ways, hexadecimal code wise. That code will be follows with a slash and 6 digits will be there over here, and it contains the 0 to 9 digits, we already know this, and A to F digits. These are the case insensitive. You can also use capital A to capital F. Okay, this is the real meaning we are using over here. You can use complete zeros also. This resembles the black color. If you are using all F's, this resembles the white color. Okay, in between you can change how many colors you want. You can change the code as ever you want. Okay, and we can also use in the way of RGB, red, green and blue. We can give the code over here, right? The proportion of red color, the proportion of green color and the proportionate of blue color. Let us suppose I am giving my proportionate red color with 52. Okay, I am giving 64 for green color and 102 for blue color. You will get a different color, which is the proportionate of 52 as red, 64 as blue and 102 as 64 as green color and 102 as a blue color. So you can use outline color in any way. Here I am using a hexadecimal 02ABEF. Like that you can use. Okay, and coming to the width, and coming to the width over here, outline width, same like outline color, you can use the outline width in this way. Okay, outline width, outline width we already discussed, like I can use in lengthwise, I can use in lengthwise, that we already know that percentile or em or pixels or centimeters, meters, feet, but most probably we use percentile, em or pixels, right? And I can also use variant, varies according to the parent, auto or 100 percentile. In percentile wise also I can give my maximum width. Okay, max width is another concept, but here you can also give 100% width here in percentile way. So I am giving 10 pixels in form of pixels, right? This is the way we are going to use the outline style, outline color, outline width. So outline style we can give in different ways, that is the solid or dashed and groove ridge, in these many different ways: none, hidden, inset, outset, dashed and double, right? And for outline color we can give in three different ways, that is the name wise and also the hexadecimal code. In way of hexadecimal code we can give either in RGB format, okay, in this format. Outline width is also the same way like outline color and everything, but we are giving this in a lengthwise, that is a percentile or pixels or em or something else. Okay, this is the way we are going to give the outline properties, that is the style, color and width. Now I just want to give all the three things in a one statement, that is the shortened property, right? So how I am going to give that shortened property, how I am going to give the shortened property, we are going to discuss now. My shortened property for CSS is outline. Outline, first outline follows with the width, follows with the width, then after color, and need to close. These three properties are there for outline, right? First is my width. I can give in any way, 1 percentile or pixels, like that. So 2.5 em or in em way also we can give, right? According to the style we can give solid, dash, double, like that. So double means two lines, and color you can give in any way, name wise or hexadecimal or in RGB format. Okay, right, this is the shorthand property for the standard outline in CSS. Okay, first we are going to discuss with the width, then we need to give the style, and then we need to give the color. This is the way we are going to give the shortened property for outline. But first thing is that style is must and should, it is required, it is must and should. These two are the optionals. First need to set this, then only we can set these two. That means I can also write 2.5 em double. Color black is the default thing automatically taken by the browser itself. Okay, black color will be taken by the browser by default. You can also make it as an optional, but double need to be given. That means the style is required in outline. This is all about the CSS outline. I hope you all understood this concept very well. And for the now, we are going to discuss the CSS text formatting. CSS text properties. Okay, how we can make the style to the text, and what are the properties, and what are the values of it, we are going to discuss now. Okay, first, regarding this text, we are having several types of properties. First, what are the properties? Text color we can change. Okay, a part of it we can also change the text align, text decoration, text transform, text direction, text shadow, letter spacing, line height, text indention, these are the different CSS text editings. Okay, the text color is the property, and text align, text decoration, a text transform, text direction, and text shadow will be there, letter spacing, line height, text indention, and word spacing. These are the properties we are going to use to the editing of a text. Okay, these are the properties, and these might having a different value. So how that values are going to be changed, we are going to see now. First coming to the color, we already know that we can give the text color in different ways, that is the name wise, hexadecimal wise, and in RGB format. So if suppose h1 is there, I'm going to give my color in way like color red or blue or like that, in name wise also. Either we can also give #0EFD12, either we can also give in RGB format 0 to 64 to 55, like that, in RGB format. The way we are going to give the color, the property will be written like this. No need to add the text over here, because text is the default one. If you give the color over here, directly it will be applicable to the text. Okay, if any background color is there, then you need to mention with a background, color like this. Okay, until and unless if you are giving directly color like this, it will directly applicable to the text. Okay, and background color we already seen in before video sessions, that directly background of the text will be given as in a background color like this. Okay, these are the properties we are using for the color. Coming to the text align here is the property we are having a h1 text align. We are going to write in this way. Okay, it might having four different values, and what are they? You can text align in left wise or in a right side, or you can also keep it in center. And one more is also there, that is the justify. Okay, if you keep the text align left, the text will be shifted to the left, and this is the default one. And if you want to keep it in a right, then keep the text align right, then it will be kept like this. Hello. If you want left, it will be like this. Okay, if you want to keep in center, then hello will be displayed in center. Justify means what? If you are having number of lines in a paragraph, Okay, you don't want to make the paragraph in this way. The lines will be ended in this way. Okay, if you make that paragraph justify, if you make that paragraph justify, so the line space will be given to each and everything, and the paragraph will be displayed in a equivalent manner. The spacing will be taken by itself, in between the words or in between the letters or whatever might be, but the paragraph will be justified equivalently to the right and left side. Okay, that is the real meaning of justify. You can also use your text align for justify. I hope you clearly understood these two. And coming to the third one, and coming to the third one, that is the text decoration. That is the text decoration. We already used this text decoration regarding the links. Did you guys remember that if the default link is there, let us suppose any link with a Gmail is there, it is automatically displayed with an underline, right? So we can remove that underline using this text decoration. Let us suppose I am having a heading with an underline. I just want to remove my underline. So text decoration, I can keep none means it could be displayed in this way like Gmail. If I am going to use underline, it will be displayed in underline. So guys, remember that underline you need to use only for the links actually. So be careful when you are using a underline in the text decoration. Okay, and most of the websites will keep the text decoration none. Why? Because it could not be act as an a link. For that purpose, automatically by default they will keep as an a none. Okay, you can also use overline. Overline means Gmail will be displayed over the line of it, and you can also use line through means Gmail like that. So several options you can use for the text decoration. Okay, coming to the text transform, you are having several things like here. You need to use the text transform in this way, and to this property we are having several values that are the uppercase, lowercase, and capitalize. Okay, if you want to display your text completely in uppercase, you can use the uppercase. If the text want to be displayed completely in lowercase, just use the lowercase. And if you want to see the text in capitalized format, you can use this thing. It's using these three values, you can make your text to be transformed in which way you want. That is the real usage of this text transform. Okay, and another one is the text direction. Text direction is having only two values, that is from right to left and left to right. If you want to display from right to left, that means right to left, RTL, right to left. Otherwise you can use LTR, that means left to right. In this format you can use the text direction. Okay, now we are going to the another one, that is the text shadow. Now we are going to see the text shadow. Okay, text shadow we can print like this. Text shadow is a property And to this property, we are having the values, like shortened property, we are having three different values. One is the vertical shadow, horizontal shadow, vertical shadow, and also the actual value. Okay, how much that one will be? Okay, so first we can use the horizontal shadow, might be the 1 pixels. Vertical shadow also will be the 1 pixels, and you can use the value over here, whatever you want. That is the default here, that is an optional, but if you want, you can use even the red color. This is the shortened property for the text shadow. So you have to write the text shadow in this way. First one will be the horizontal shadow, and second one will be the vertical shadow, and you can give the color even either in name wise or hexadecimal wise or in RGB way. Okay, but it could be in a color wise. Okay, whatever the color you will give, the shadow will be displayed in that color. Okay, and coming to the next one, letter spacing. Letter spacing. So we are having a text each and like this, hello. Okay, did any space there over here? No. If we want to give some space over here, we have to use this in this way, right? So you can give the letter spacing with lengthwise. That is the positive value. It starts from 0, like that. You can give 1.5 or like that, 2.5 em, or 20 pixels or 1 pixels, like that. You can give the value. According to that value, there will be specified some space in between the letters. There could be some space in between the letters. If you don't want to give, don't use this. If you don't want to give any letter spacing, don't use this. Okay, and line height. If you are using any para, if you are using any para over here, hello world, welcome to Ratan IT. Welcome to Ratan IT. This is my para. Okay, this is my paragraph. I'm having two lines of paragraph of over here. Line height. Line height means what? You can give the line height. Negative values are also allowed here. You can give 1 pixels or 2 pixels or like that. You can also give in em or percentile wise. Okay, in length wise we are, means that the line height between this is 1 pixels over here. If you are increasing 2, it might be increased some more. Welcome will be displayed over here, 2 pixels. Okay, this is the way we are going to specify the line height of a paragraph or anything else. Okay, we can also have the text indent. Text indent also we are giving. Text indent we can give in 1 pixels or 2 pixels, like lengthwise. Okay, that identification of that text will be given in a weight. Okay, word spacing. According to be here, 2 words are there here, between only 1 space will be there over here. If you want to increase the space of it, you can use the word spacing. You can use the word spacing. That also you need to give in a lengthwise. You can also use the negative values. Negative values are allowed over here. If you want to use 0.5 pixels like this, even point wise also you can use. This is the way we are going to use the properties of a text in CSS. We are going to discuss CSS font. Okay, CSS font is containing several properties. And what are that properties? The main properties are font family, and also font size, font variant, okay, and style and font weight. these are the five properties we are using for CSS. These are the five properties we are using for CSS: font family, font size, font variant, font style, font weight. So before going to the properties, first of all you want to know that what is a generic family, what is a font family. Okay, generic family in the sense it is like serif or sans serif, like that. That means that it is not having such variants, there are no variant for that. But coming to the font family, we are having several values that are Times New Roman, Arial, Calibri. So this is the latest version. So latest version, they had been included many over here. So how I am going to use this font family in CSS way? See, if I am having a H1, for my heading I need to add a font family. So just add a font family over here. Font family, I can use Arial or Calibri. Suppose I want to use more, I need to mix Calibri with some other font family. For that purpose also you need to make it as in a double quotations and make a comma and just add Times New Roman or Vardhana comma Arial, like that. Okay, like that you can add, like that you can add more and more font families in a for a one selector. Okay, for heading the main thing is Calibri over here, and I'm going to mix the Times New Roman, Vardhana and Arial over here. This is the way we are going to display the font family. Okay, and we can also make the font size. Font size, I'm going to write over here itself. Font size will be, you can use in pixels or in 100 percentile or em and lengthwise, we already discussed. But here, if however you are giving for the selectors like header or parameter like that, you will be very 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 confident that for which selector you are going to use. Let us suppose for font size I am giving 10 pixels over here. Okay, suppose I am using a paragraph over here. For this paragraph also I am using my font size 10 pixels over here. Now did user know that is this heading, which one is heading, which one is paragraph? No, that is the main reason that headings and paragraphs came into the existence in HTML to enter the code. So for a paragraph, font size default is 16 pixels. Default is 16 pixels. Okay, for heading is also having like 32 pixels. So no one is having that tried to change the heading and pixels of font size. It's not an order, but if you want to use, you can use. But see the confusion here. The user don't know which one is the heading, which one is the paragraph. Okay, that is the main confusion getting over here. To make avoid that, please use heading as in a parameter, no font or no nothing like that. Okay, you can use this font size for the another selectors that will be like division or images or like whatever the text you are adding over there. For image, if you want to write a paragraph over here, if it is an image, you need to add some description over here. You can add in a paragraph wise and you can give some font size according to the requirement. You can use this font size. Okay, coming to the font variant. Coming to the font variant. Font variant is having different values. The variant you can keep as in a normal. Normal is the default. Normal variant, you can use normal. Normal is the default, and you can also use the small caps. That means it will be displayed in a small capital letter. The first letter will be capital letter A, big, well, combination of like. You can also use the paragraph with the small caps if you want. Okay, And now we are going to discuss the font style. Now we are going to discuss the font style here. Okay, font style we can use like this, font style. To this property we are having different values. The first one is normal or italic or oblique or bold. Like whatever you want you can use. Normal is the default one. If you keep your font style in italic, the text will be displayed in italic way. Oblique and italic both are very equivalent, but it is a leaning mode, and very few people are using this. In place of this, normally we are using the italic now, and bold means you already know that will be displayed in strong with the capital letters. We are going to see this in application. Now we are going to the font weight. Okay, here font weight we can use from 100 to 900. Okay, font weight we can write like this, and this property will contains from 100 to 900. How much values you want you can give in that way, and you can also give the normal or sometimes like bold. Okay, this is the way we are going to give the font weight. And five properties we are using for the font, that is the font family, font size, font variant, font style, and also the font weight. Thank you for watching this video, and for more videos please subscribe to our channel Ratan IT.